Good morning. This is Lynda Cromar, and I am recording this in behalf of my Wake Up Empowered friends and teammates. And I wanted to share with you some things that you really kind of need to do if you're a brand new newbie and you have never done any kind of contacting. And George has the perfect formula. I am not in any way going to replace that because it's perfect. It works. Absolutely works, and it is definitely the formula. But if you are brand new in Facebook and have never used it really for this purpose, or if you've used it wrong, like I have in many, many times, I would recommend that you follow this training I'm going to share with you. So here we go. One thing I want to point out to you is that when people are either looking at your profile because they want to be friends with you, or if you have requested a friendship with other people, the very first thing people are going to do is they're going to come to your profile and they're going to look at what you share. They're going to look at your pictures. They're going to look at everything that you are doing. As you can see, I am actually following George's plan here. But anyway, you want to make sure that you are making your profile as inviting as possible. For instance, I do recommend that you don't actually put up a company logo or use it for your own personal profile picture. Try to find a headshot that is showing your face well, because if you look down here at this little profile down here, at this little thumbnail, it's very small and you cannot see the face very much. In fact, I really should crop this even more and take it down to where it's just me and no background, which I probably will. But find something. It doesn't have to be a professional picture. In fact, it needs to be you as close to who you are right now as possible. You don't want to put up, I see a lot of people putting up children pictures. I don't know. Sometimes they're you as a child, and sometimes they're your child. Now, it doesn't mean that your child shouldn't be somewhere in your profile, but don't use it as your personal profile picture. You can put it up in here if you want to, and many people do, and that works out perfectly. And then another thing is that you want to make sure that you are giving people every possibility to understand who you are so that they know how to contact you and what you stand for and the things that you offer. Because if you don't do that, people will go away. Because I'm seeing a trend right now that I really think is very destructive to anybody that is trying to have a home business, and that is that they are hiding their information. They are actually saying, I have in here that it says, ask Lynda for her city, ask Lynda for her work, ask Lynda for her email, ask Lynda for her phone number. I recommend you do not do that, because of the fact that if you are hiding all your information, I can promise you people are not going to send an email to you asking you for that information, because they think that means that you don't want them to contact you. Now, is that what you truly want? You don't want them to talk to you? No, you want them to say, hey, this person is open and this person is willing to talk to me. This person has actually offered my phone number, and I have two. I have a work line and I have my cell line, and I have a real email, and I have a Google Talk, and I have a Skype. I mean, they have lots of choices in which they can contact me. Now, I don't get a lot of phone calls. I get a lot of those automated phone calls, and that's okay. Those people are trying. I don't answer them, but they are trying at least. And so one thing for sure is, well, I'll do it in here just so that you see where it is. You would edit this, and you could actually take it out, or you could actually say, I want it to only be me. And when you put it only as me, then that's where you get that message of ask Lynda for her city or ask Lynda for her phone number. And I recommend that you keep it at public. When you keep it at public, your friends will see it, yes. But also new people that might request your friendship will also see it. Or if you are requesting a new friendship, that person will see all of your information. You do not want to hide this. And another thing you want to make sure and do is you want to fill out things as completely as you possibly can. Now, there's it's kind of hidden, and I don't know why, but there is an About Me section down here. And what you want to do with that is you want to actually write a little story about yourself and who you are. This is not really a big pitch about your business. A lot of people do that. But you want to tell a story about who you are, and what kind of life you've lived, and kind of a little bit about your journey. And it will be completely unique as far as who you are. And then you do have the option of being able to put in a website if you want to. And then another place where you can share who you are is in the life events. And these are easy to do. Those are in your status updates. And it's kind of fun because I'll show this one to you. You can actually have a picture. You can actually have a little description. And you can have a link. And this is just one more way that you can actually share who you are. And it's okay because nobody is going to be offended by that. And then, of course, anytime you travel, what other kinds of things that you have done in your life? Of course, when you got married, when you had children. But don't just leave it to be work events. Make sure that you're putting fun events, like I traveled to Miami, Florida. I put that in there. And, you know, other things that I think are valuable that people want to know. And then it's good to have some links. Now, will they click on them? Sometimes. I know myself, I love to go and check and see what people are up to. And the first three links here are actually blogs. So they can go to my blogs and they can learn more about me. And then another thing is that you have the option of turning your work education into an actual fan page. This is a fan page. It's, if you are not careful, this can become a funny little kind of nonsense link that takes you absolutely nowhere. So instead of making your title something like I am an entrepreneur or I work online or any of those kind of things, if you have a fan page, which most people that are kind of building their business does have, and this fan page is really new. I've only had it for a couple of months and I have not done any advertising to build it. It was all from organic likes that it has gotten its 96 likes. And I haven't worked that hard to build it. But one thing that you can do is you can share that you share free training and resources for people. This is attractive to people. They like to see that. And this is another fan page that I had. And then after I've done that, I have some other things like self-employed. And if you'll look at this, self-employed goes off in a funny direction, which is not actually your own personal site. So you don't want to take them away from where you are. And then, finally, after you make sure that you're complete, you are complete with what you have there. Then on the other side, and George shared a lot of this, so I won't go into this in detail, make sure you're sharing some value. And so I do recommend you go back to George's training and understand exactly what he does daily, because that's the part you want to do. Now, if you do not have any of the correct kind of friends that you want, then you need to go and find friends every single day that you want to connect with. You have the complete choice. And those friends need to be people that you would like to have in your business. So what kinds of interests do you have that would actually be something that they would like you, would connect with you on? Okay, so I like to connect with other network marketers. So first of all, I'm going to say people who like network marketing. And actually, I have a search that I pick up all the time, and that is this fan page, which is Network Marketing Pro, Eric Worre, which I'm sure you're familiar with. And also, you can filter this a little bit more. You could actually change all of these things here on the side. One thing I like to do right away is say that I want people that are not my friends, so that I'm getting a new list of people that I have not probably had any contact with. And then you can actually invite them to become your friends, send them a nice message. And again, I'm going to defer to George as far as the hustle goes, because you can absolutely start friending them and sharing the George's hustle with these new people. And then another thing is to realize that you want to choose people that you have a lot in common with. And one thing you might notice is that a lot of these people are mutual friends already, have mutual friends. And what makes that nice is that when you go to send that first message, it's not going to go into the other box for the most part. Some of them do for some reason, but the majority of them go into their inbox, which is very key because obviously, when you want to create a friendship, you really want to make sure that they see your message. And I know myself, when somebody takes the time to send me a message when they're making friends with me, then I will take the time to go over and see who they are and what they're all about. And I will snoop around all over their personal profile. I will snoop all their links. I will look at who they are. And usually I will accept it. So that is what I want to share with you today, is that you want to get set up correctly so that you can do that hustle with the most success. And I truly believe that no matter whether you're brand new or whether you've been on Facebook for a while, that you can absolutely create whatever you want if you consistently take the action.